Paula J. Giddings was born in Yonkers, New York.
My parents were educators. We had lots of books in the house. And my father was also politically active. So I had that perspective when I, as growing up in Yonkers, New York. It was a very heady time. And it's one of the reasons why I chose Howard.
Matriculating at Howard during the tumultuous 60s, Paula Giddings was not immune to the changes taking place on campus and off.
During the time I was at Howard, it was when Howard voted for its first, elected its first homecoming queen with a natural hairstyle. And this really began sort of as a beginning of a momentum of political change and of the sit-in at Howard. So, but it was, I remember, and I talked to my friends as well, and we all had very similar experiences of getting my afro and surprising my poor mother with it, and pretty upset about it. She said, you know, I sent you to school looking one way, and here you come looking this way. So there was this wonderful electric recognition of a change and of wanting to better understand and then better communicate what was happening outside of the campus of the black, because you remember these are the years too of the Black Power movement. We went from the civil rights movement to the Black Power movement.
After leaving Howard University Press, she became an editor at Random House. Then she started a nomadic journalistic career that took her from New York to Philadelphia to Paris. As a globe-trotting journalist during the 70s, she interviewed everyone, from Jimmy Carter to Winnie Mandela to Idi Amin.
After I graduated from Howard, I worked a couple of years at Howard University Press, which was the first black academic press in the nation. And being introduced to Gwendolyn Brooks and Margaret Walker and Richard Wright and Ralph Ellison and so many in that period was eye-opening, and it was startling and beautiful in many ways, and it really changed me.
Paula Giddings became a prolific author, including one book that rang close to her Howard experience, In Search of Sisterhood, Delta Sigma Theta and the Challenge of the Black Sorority Movement.
The sororities in general and Delta also was a place where black women could exercise leadership and learn about leadership. And many of them left the sororities to then become leaders in the public sector. I was very interested in looking at how that worked. And I was very interested in the idea of sisterhood.
In 2017, Paula J. Giddings, the little girl from Yonkers, who so loved words, was inducted into the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. Howard University congratulates Ms. Paula J. Giddings, our 2018 Charter Day honoree.